look at this event mission right here, my boys. Like, they giving Penelope recruit tickets again. Like, nobody wants a Penelope recruit ticket. Like, if I want to save nature, let me save nature with Ceres. I don't give a fuck about Penelope.
Oh, shit. Here we go again.
What is up, YouTube? It's your boy, John and Dude, and I'm coming back at you with another Baseball Superstars 2022 video, my boys. All right, my boys, we're going to try to keep this one somewhat short, somewhat sweet, somewhat quick. I'm going to try to drop some knowledge on you guys on what I think. This is my opinion of my favorite and my top five trainers. And we're going to go over that today, right now. Let's get it going, my boys. All right, my boys. So we're going to start this countdown with the actual who I consider top five. And I'm going to be honest, it's really hard to choose just five trainers because there are so many trainers that are good at this game. But this is personally my top five and who I think is truly amazing for the top five. Now, my runner-up will probably be Art, because I do like Art's skill set. I do like what Art brings to the table. So we are going to talk about Art a little bit, but Art didn't make my top five, unfortunately. But I do love what Art does have. Art has training reward all. He has an actual good skill set as well. But mainly in his skills, he has the actual training reward all, which for a dual trainer is really great. It's hard to beat training reward all for a dual trainer, and Art has that. So he's a really great trainer, but he just didn't make my top five because of synergy-wise, why he's great if you are running Perfect Lions. I don't run Perfect Lions, so this is my top five. This is not just whatever. This is personally who I consider my top five trainers. So who did make my top five, though, is going to be Hayter. Hayter is my number five trainer. Why do I like Hayter so much? Well, Hayter is a dual trainer. Hayter combo is really good with your girl Isis as well. Doesn't really combo with anybody outside of Isis, but she does combo with Isis as well. She has a level 3 UR skill as well. So if we go actually to her actual skills here, to her normal skills, she has a level 3 perfect pitch. Level 3 UR skills, I do value trainers who have that. She also has level 3 submarine, level 3 V slider, which are actually really good. So she's just a great trainer all around. You know, she brings one of my favorite pitches, which is slow curve. Really good trainer. Doesn't really have the best scenario, of course, which is why she's not higher than the, you know, my bottom five. But she's still a really good trainer. Like, Hayter, if I had to pull for her again, I definitely would do it. She has tremendous value. I mean, I've had Hayter since the beginning, and even now, she's still being utilized. So, great value for Hayter. Can't complain about it. My number four is going to be your girl, Bassett. That's my number four. Bassett got a costume recently. It makes her the only duel right now with a costume as well. Why is Bassett so great? Well, once again, she brings that level 3 UR skill where with Idle Swing, you can actually not have to bring in Michaela or not have to bring in Rachel in order to get a level 5 Idle Swing because of Bassett. And there are decks out there that do exist where people are not bringing in one or the other. But Michaela and Rachel are so good. Who cares about the overkill of Idle Swing most of the time? Most of the time, you're just going to take that in away. But she's a really good trainer, has one of the best super skills in the game now because of the costume. Upgraded glove now because of the costume. Really great trainer, has really good synergy with a lot of people. Has some good combo events as well with Rachel and Anubis, which you use them a lot of times when you do use Bassett. So she's a really good trainer, definitely my top four dual trainer as well. Good skill set, no way I would change her at all. So Bassett is once again taking that top number four spot for me. My number three trainer is going to be no other than your girl Isis. So why Isis, you ask? Isis is OP, my boys. First of all, let's look at her combo events, like on her story. Isis combos with Haythers, combos with Rowena, combos with Belita. Like, she is the glue of the Force Elf deck, my boys. Without Isis, it doesn't exist. Like, she is the glue that holds that whole deck together, providing three combo events, providing excellent skill synergy as well. If we look at her actual skills right here, while she is left-hander, you don't want no left-handers for Force Elves. But she's providing a level 3 slurve, heavy ball, giving you more slow curve action, which is an overkill because you do get it from Belita and stuff as well. But she provides so much more. The two starting pitcher resolve, where you are getting max starting pitcher resolve because of her as well. She's a really good trainer. Now, she hasn't got a costume yet, so her and Hater super skill is trash for now. But one day, they'll get a costume like Bassette. And their super skill would be so amazing as well, where they would have no holes in their game. But she is number three for me right now because of everything she provides. Even when you look at her actual detailed stats, she has the personal trigger training rate, which helps out in four stealths, plus 20% there. She's a 240% trainer, so nothing amazing right there, but she's still freaking amazing. UR gear from Heron Hather as well. All duels provide UR gear, which is great. But definitely my number three spot. Wouldn't change it at all. Isis, you deserve it. Now, number two, I'm not gonna lie, like, there are some iffies right now, you know what I mean? Like, I'm gonna give number two to Hyper. And I'm gonna explain why my number one is my number one when you see my number one. So Hyper right now is my number two. She would be my number one, but my number one got some fishy stuff going on right now. So Hyper takes the number two spot in my top five right now. Hyper is amazing. To me, she's still the best batter in the game, period. Hands down, Hyper is the best bat you can have in your deck. She provides, first of all, the sword that she provides is so freaking amazing. I'm taking that sword regardless. So Hyper has the best looking bat in the game to me. Best cosmetic looking bat, period, in the game. Then she's training reward all. She's a dual. Training reward all dual. So freaking amazing. Her skill set is amazing. Her combos is amazing. We look at her combos. Combo with Aura. Combo with Caroline. Combo with Michaela. She has a combo with every center fielder in the game that's a UR. So if you're running a center fielder, Hyper must go in a center fielder deck, period, because she combos with every UR center fielder. Hyper is amazing. So not only does she has that, like I said, UR bat, training reward all, personal training trigger rate as well. Like, she got it all going on. She's all that in a bag of chips, my boys. Even her super skill for it to not be a costume super skill is great. It's only going to get better when she gets a costume. And I do love that it's a home run rate up when winning, because a lot of times I am winning. And so now you get the hit up in the home run rate up when you're winning. That's going to come in handy later on once she gets a costume like Bassette, my boys. When she gets a costume like Bassette, her super skill is going to be amazing as well as everything else that she already provides. And her skill set, my boys, is amazing. Her skill set, top batter blessing, level 3, my boys. So level 3 UR skill, level 3 home run mastery, level 2 hit, like, just a great skill set to go along. And what I do like about her skill set, she's not providing a batting style on any of her skills, meaning that all her skills is plus to any of the idols you run with, because you know you're going to already get idol swing with the idols. So she's just helping them go further along. Really, really great. The best batter in the game to me is right here. And the reason why she's going to be number one, she's in pitching decks now. She's in the batting ditch now. She is a all-round trainer, my boy. It's Michaela. Michaela is my number one trainer at this time right now. And the reason why is she's in both dicks. You wouldn't expect the batter to be in a freaking pitching dick, but she is there. My girl Michaela is there. And she's freaking amazing, period, anyway. So she provides training reward all, as we all know. She has placement, as we all know. Personal training trigger rate as well, 20%. So my girl Michaela has it all. Only int trainer as well. The only UR int trainer with placement. You won't find another. She's unique right there. So she has a good super skill as well, as you know. But the main thing about her, her combo, she only combos with Hyper and Rachel, which is who you're really going to use her. Not going to really use her with any of the other trainers, which she does combo with. But you're just not going to use Michaela with them in endgame. But what makes Michaela, like I say, OP is, you know, in Shining Angels, she gets the week 3, 5, and 7, where she always has the special training placement. And when you're running her in a pitcher dicks, you're going to try to combine those missions, those two int missions from Michaela and the int mission from Belita. And after you get both of those, you're going to try to stack those and get a 50%, the biggest 50% boost that you can get on a triple or a quad that's possible. And she's in the pitching dicks. She's in the batting dicks. She's everywhere. Michaela right now is my number one trainer. I wouldn't say anybody's better than her in the current state of the game right now. So Michaela, it's a must pull when she's around, because she's that freaking great right now, my boys. My number one trainer, easily. Hyper's a must pull too. Brissette's a must pull as well. Freaking Isis and Hather, must pulls, man. Like, all these people is must pulls to me. If I didn't have them, I would be pulling for them. And they've had such long value, my boys. I've had these trainers forever, besides Hyper, of course, because she just came. But the value with them has always been great. But set value had tanked for a little bit, then it shot way up again with the Shining Angels buff. So that's going to be my top five, my boys. And that's who I think is my top five. If you agree or if you disagree, go ahead and leave it in that comment below, my boys, and let me know what you think and what your top five in this game is. But with that said, my boys, that's going to be it for today's video. You guys have a good one. Peace, my boys.